Now, this is my new Wi-Fi router, and I hate this thing because as soon as I get a bit farther away from it or have the audacity to sit on the couch in my living room, the Wi-Fi reception becomes pretty terrible and the speed goes down noticeably. And what bothers me the most is that this thing cost me 100 euro more than my old router that I still use upstairs for Wi-Fi. And this one offers a way better Wi-Fi coverage. I mean, look, these distances upstairs and downstairs are about the same. And my new router only achieves a signal strength of -78 dBm, while my old one does -60 dBm, which, by the way, is quite a big difference. So what's the deal with this new router? And can we possibly improve it? Well, in this video, I will show you how such a Wi-Fi signal strength boost is more or less easily achievable. And while we're at it, test the Wi-Fi hack I've seen years ago on YouTube. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Rohde & Schwarz, one of my trusty test equipment manufacturers, who, of course, also make oscilloscopes that come with an integrated spectrum analyzer. Such an analyzer is super important when it comes to determining what frequencies your voltage signal consists of. Now, using and understanding such an analyzer is not that easy though, but thankfully Rohde & Schwarz is giving out a free PDF about spectrum analyzer fundamentals. So click the link below and have fun with it. Now, to get some decent reference values, I started out with installing the app NetSpot, uploaded my downstairs house layout, and took Wi-Fi strength measurements in every room in order to end up with these two Wi-Fi heat maps. Green means we got a decent strength, and red means forget Wi-Fi. And as you would expect, we got good results around the router. But the farther we get away from it, or the more walls are between us and the router, the weaker the signal gets, with a measured minimum of -78 dBm and -85 dBm. At this point, you probably wonder why we got two maps, with the second one featuring more reds, aka weak signals. Well, as it turns out, modern routers can use the newest 5 GHz frequency, as well as the old school 2.4 GHz frequency to transfer data. So which one is which, you might ask? And to answer that, let's think about radio frequency theory for a second, and the fact that such a router sends out these frequencies as waves. The length of those can be calculated by dividing the speed of light by the frequency of the wave, which equals a length of around 125 mm for 2.4 GHz and 60 mm for 5 GHz. So since the 5 GHz wave is shorter, it cannot only transfer more data per second, which is a big selling point of this technology, but it also has a harder time traveling further and penetrating solid objects. That makes it pretty easy to figure out which heat map equals which frequency. And that brings us to the question how to improve things. And I'm not talking about the super obvious options here, like going into your router settings and adjusting the transmission power to 100%. No, I'm talking about real hardcore electronics improvements. And in my opinion, there are basically only two. And those are amplifying our Wi-Fi signal and or making sure that we use the best antenna. So first off, the amplifying solution, which should be possible to do with either a transistor or operational amplifier. I mean, I showed you in tons of previous videos that amplifying an AC voltage signal with these components is easily possible. The big challenge here though is of course the high frequency of the Wi-Fi signal. But luckily for us, there do exist special RF components just for that. And while thinking more about a fitting circuit and realizing that of course AliExpress offers pre-made ones like this, I realized that this solution might be illegal to pull off. You see, the legally allowed transmit power for 2.4 GHz is 100 milliwatts, and for 5 GHz it is 200 milliwatts. And my router, of course, already operates at these power levels normally. Meaning boosting these signals even more can get us into trouble. So let's rather switch to solution number 2. And here, let's firstly open up my new and old router to see what antennas they're using. Let's start with the old one, that comes with two PCB antennas on a separate PCB in one corner, and in the other corner we got a straight piece of metal. This kind of antenna is probably the simplest one, because as long as the length of it equals a half or quarter wavelength of the AC Wi-Fi signal, it should resonate with it, and thus propagate the electromagnetic Wi-Fi wave as good as possible through space. And with a length of around 34 mm, it is truly around one quarter of the 2.4 GHz wavelength. Now if we switch over to my new router however, then we cannot find such a simple antenna, but instead three PCB antennas, which after doing a Google search turn out to be designed for 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. So the first thing I wanted to try out was adding such a simpler antenna. And luckily for me, I still had some generic 2.4 GHz antennas laying around, which ultimately are also just a stick of metal. In addition to those, I also needed such IPX to SMA converters. And all I had to do was unplugging two old antennas from their IPX ports, snug in the converter wires, plug them in instead, hook up the antennas and put everything back together. After then getting the router back to its original place and securing the antennas temporarily, it was time to go for another measurement run. And here are the 2.4 GHz results before and after using external antennas. I think it is pretty easy to spot that things look a lot better now, with strength increases by 10 dBm in my lap, at the couch and also the dining table. But if we switch to 5 GHz, then we only got very minor improvements, which we can hopefully expand with these dual 2.4/5 GHz antennas that I got from the internet. Out of curiosity, I opened them up as well and was greeted with a weird looking metal shape that was around 50 mm long and that was connected in the middle to the wire. This is a so-called dipole antenna, and its overall and individual lengths do kind of correspond with 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. So let's give them a try by removing the old antennas, screwing the new ones in, and once again going for a run inside my house. And after having a closer look at the results, I gotta say that the 5 GHz strength truly increased quite a bit, by around 5 dBm to 10 dBm. But on the other hand, the 2.4 GHz strength decreased in comparison to before, meaning my final antenna solution is to basically utilize one of each kind. And at this point I have to say that I was rather happy with the internet connection, because I could finally comfortably use it on my couch and get almost double the speed as before. One final improvement we could try though before going into crazy territory is logging into the router and changing the 5 GHz channel to one above 100. The reason is that these channels equal a frequency range between 5.5 and 5.7 GHz, which not only closer correlates with the length of our antenna, but in this frequency range you can also use a higher transmit power of 1000 milliwatts, which my router apparently utilizes. But sadly, this change did only very slightly increase the signal strength, meaning it was time to test out a Wi-Fi hack I've seen years ago on YouTube, and it is this so-called Wi-Fi beam antenna that even comes with built instructions. So while I create this thing out of cardboard, copper tape, nuts and bolts, let me tell you that the antenna types we looked at so far were omnidirectional ones, meaning the radiated electromagnetic waves travel in all horizontal directions equally. But as you can see, according to my house layout, we do not really need much Wi-Fi here, but instead more here. And for that, we can use a directional antenna that, like the name implies, concentrates our waves in one direction. And that is hopefully what I just completed building. So after hooking it up and positioning it, I did my measurements one last time, only to find out that this directional antenna performs quite a bit worse than the omnidirectional ones we tested before. So yeah, this thing might look cool, but in the end I will stick to my classical antennas. And with that being said, I think I upgraded and tested my Wi-Fi enough for today. And I hope you learned something new and maybe are able to improve your Wi-Fi as well. And keep in mind that when everything fails, you can always use mesh repeaters. But anyway, if you enjoyed the show, then don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and consider supporting it on Patreon to keep it going. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.